Hi, this is Ellie, and welcome to the brand new series on ChatGPT prompt engineering, specifically designed around prompt patterns. Let us explore in detail what prompt patterns are. If you have signed up for ChatGPT and have interacted with it, you have already taken the first step in the journey of prompt engineering. Prompt literally is the user interface or screen where you provide input to computer program via textual input. Prompt in natural language also means an act that encourages or causes someone to do something. Since here we are talking in terms of language models like ChatGPT, where your screen where you type messages is called the prompt. Whenever you type something in that input field, it causes the large language model to do something. End result of that being generating a response. That is the complete cycle. Your prompt causes the large language model to do some processing and generate a response. Prompt can be a question, instruction, or some statement or set of statements from the user. Now, when we interact with the model and provide a prompt, we have a rough sketch of the type of output we expect to be generated. A good language model would generate a response closer to the one you are expecting. But this is tricky since there is no magic involved. It's not a mind reader. It's a software algorithm trained on natural language using vast data sets. It, at best, tries to predict the best response given the input from you. So we can say that the output it generates is as much as a function of user input as it is of the training data that it was trained on. So while the model has been trained on petabytes of internet resources and has billions of parameters used to control, it cannot generate your expected output until you provide it with clear, specific input. The art, or rather science, of coming up with an input that would result in output expected by you is called prompt engineering. While technologies like ChatGPT, Bard, Llama make inroads into lives of billions of people, each querying them for vastly different questions and scenarios, researchers have been trying to identify common problems people faced while interacting with large language models, and also identify techniques that brilliantly attempt to solve the problems by creatively crafting the input prompt and force or fine-tune the model to customize its output as a solution. These identified patterns of carefully crafted input techniques that nudge model towards a particular desired goal have come to be known as prompt patterns and are increasingly being used to use large language models even more creatively in everyday scenarios. With these patterns, user can enforce constraints on generated output, change format of interaction, and ensure relevant information is included. While large language models are a relatively new phenomena and prompt patterns and prompt engineering are even newer concepts, software design patterns are well-established techniques developed by software developers for decades. Names of common design patterns, which are usable techniques to solve common software engineering problems, are a shared and well-known vocabulary for people in that field. So it was only natural that prompt patterns borrowed the same structure of documenting as software patterns did. You don't need to be a software developer to understand that documentation, though. It is pretty simple structure meant to program you to understand each subsequent pattern with ease. Only the first few ones are the hardest to digest, but don't worry about it at all. Let's explore. So each pattern has the following structure: a name and classification, which uniquely identifies pattern by name and ideally indicates the problem that is being addressed. These are usually assigned to categories, which we shall come to later. The intent and context describes the problem it solves and goals it achieves. Problem should ideally be independent of any domain. Third is the motivation, provides the rationale for the problem and explains why solving it is important. Explanation is provided in context of people trying to solve problem informally without using the pattern to illustrate how using pattern improves upon the informal way. Then come structure and key ideas. These provides fundamental contextual statements used in the prompt and the key ideas they provide to the language model, causing it to change its behavior in a certain way. This is followed by example usage, which demonstrates how prompt pattern is used in practice via examples. And lastly, the consequences summarize the pros and cons of applying the pattern and provide guidance on how to adopt different contexts. Right, this concludes our introduction to prompt patterns. We shall go ahead discussing the categories of patterns in upcoming videos, followed by a dedicated video on each pattern. If you like the content so far, please do give a thumbs up and do subscribe to be notified of upcoming videos. Thank you and goodbye.